From Northeast Community Credit Union Ballpark, we bid you a very pleasant good afternoon and welcome. An overcast day. Hope we can get this thing in. As we bring you, on an overcast Friday, Elizabethan Cyclone Baseball. Cyclones in at 3-5 on the season, and Morristown West at 7-2 today's opponent. Jackson Buckles on the hill for the Cyclones. And so he'll go to work on the Morristown West Trojans again with a record of 3-5. Again, good afternoon. Thank you for being with us wherever you may be. Our camera operator for the time being will be the one, the only, Carrie Taylor, ladies and gentlemen. We call her Ray Ray because she's a ray of sunshine. That's what Jason says anyway. So, what?
I said, don't forget it.
Oh, we don't forget it. No, we're not going to. You won't let us forget it. Here's Jackson Buckles going to work on the lead man. It'll be Jordan Watson from Morristown West. Overcast skies. We moved this thing up because rains are coming, and it's not far away, I can tell you that. Buckles to bring it, and it's upstairs, ball one. Jackson pitched the other night in Unicoi County and had a really good performance. So, first base. We'll run around the defense for you in just a second. Upstairs, Bugs Meadows at short. Third base, Red Slagle. Second base, Justin Whitehead. And at first base is Bryson Rowland. Logan Campbell to left. Center field, Braden Buckles. Right field, Jariah Griffin. And a high, towering pop back and out of play here on an overcast and windy day here at the ballpark. So we've had all kinds of weather. We had 75-degree temperatures against Unicoi County last night. Not as nice. It wasn't bad. Today it's overcast with rain threatening. Swing and a miss. Strike two. Two balls and two strikes. Hello, Samantha Wampler and Aubrey Cole and Jonathan and Kim Morton. Thank you all for being with us. Jimmy Buck. Buckles gets his sign, the big man. He's a hoss. 2-2 offering plateward, and it's strike three called. Double C Western Supply strikeout credited for Jackson Buckles. One away. It's a good start with the big man. He'll go to work on Charlie DeWald, shortstop. Hello, Brian Hamby. How are you doing, sir? Right-hand batting shortstop. And it's sailed to the backstop, ball one. One-oh count. Fouled him back, 1-1. Carrie's got us the latest basketball score, so she's here till Tucker gets here. And I know you all don't care about the camera alignment, but hello, Kendall Treadway, our outstanding volleyball coach at T.A. Duggar. And a good mama, too. 1-1 pitch from Buckles brings it, and it's swing and a miss, 1-2. Just got a piece of it. So Buckles got him on the ropes, and one ball and two strikes here to lead this ball game. Again, skies are overcast, rain due in here about 6:30. Supposed to rain all day tonight, all day tomorrow. So we need to rain green things up a little bit. Swing and a miss. Double C strikeout number two, Double C Western Supply. Two away for right fielder Bryson Shepherd. We're joined in the press box by our, hey, Connie Helms, how you doing, lady? By our outstanding soccer goalie for the boys team, Tucker Taylor, in the house. You can hear the wind. We're up here in the press box. I guess you can hear the wind on the headset. The wind's kicking up already. This one outside, and it's 2-0 now. They have Gavin Mitchell in the mound. We've got Jackson Buckles. Misses upstairs. Hello, Tammy Blevins. How you doing, lady? Doug Street, Danny Wilson. See how this does right here? It's constant. The other one doesn't do that. I'm ready to. Here's your Rijah Massengale batting number 8. And Shepherd draws a 2-out walk. So 2 out of the inning for Morristown West. Here's Cody Blair. They've already started back here behind us. They tend to get a little testy one with another. So, you know why? Because they're so much alike. That's the problem. Are you leaving anytime soon? She says, when I get a break, I'll leave. I said, just call the game, Tom. Let him be back behind you. Your right-hand batter, Cody Blair, catcher, and it's bounced up. They're good eye hooks down. The second he goes, here's a throw, and he's in with a stolen base for Bryson Shepherd in scoring position now for Morristown West again at 7-2 record-wise on the season. We played them earlier in the year, lost down there 5-1, so this is the return match betwixt the two. So again, our record on the season at 3-5, and they are 7-2. So Jackson Buckles, wind blowing here right to left the ballpark. Buckles' jersey flapping a little bit. That's the kind of wind that's coming upstairs, and it's 2-1 now. Hello, Robert Barnes and Travis Bishop, and hello to Tammy Blevins and Shauna Lane out there somewhere. Sam Hobson, Doug Street, Marty Willis, Brian Hamby. I think we're up to date with the folks. You're nice enough to say hello. We're nice enough to say hello back here. Hello, Sharon Irwin. So 3-1, Buckles, two outs, strikeout, walk, and he's 3-1 now behind on the catcher, the cleanup batter, Cody Blair. Pitching, and it's upstairs, ball four. So back-to-back strikeouts, now back-to-back base on balls for our starting pitcher, and he'll go to work on your two-out batter again.
Paxton Seal.
Morristown always has a seal. Ever since I've been around calling games, they've always had a young man named Seal, and this is no different. Okay. Thought he had goosebumps. Hello, Gary Harrison. Hello, Amy Willis. Two out, two on here. First inning. Buckles, he's rare back and put this third out away and like our first shots at the offensive side of things here in the ball game. Buckles leans in, gets his sign. Hello to Lee Click. Jackson brings it. It's upstairs, ball one. Looks like, and I'm not a pitching coach, looks like he is, yeah, wandering around aimlessly. I'm not sure that's how you spell aimlessly, A-M-O-S-L-Y, mostly in the woods. There you go. She's out in the woods, wandering around. Swing and a miss, nice pitch. Looks like his release, he's releasing just a little high, and it sails on him. He's not following through, but that time he did. Hello to our superintendent, Richard Van Us. Had his son on today at the Tom Taylor Sports Show. Had a great report live from Charlotte from Bryce. Texas Longhorns tomorrow night. Next round. Upstairs, 2-1. Are these all finals, ma'am? Thank you. Northwestern beat Florida Atlantic by 12. Colgate, Baylor. Baylor run them off the floor. Beat them 92-67. San Diego State, 4-point winner of Alabama Birmingham. And Marquette defeats Western Kentucky inside and tight. And I would assume UConn's underway and Clemson's underway and probably Auburn and Yale are underway. So we'll have one of the two Taylors behind us. Keep up with that. Bad reception in the woods. Okay, aimlessly, you're hilarious. This one, a bad handle foul back. She corrected her spelling, said it's bad out in the woods. The reception's not good. I understand. Behind that big old oak tree, I get it. Hello, Donna Treadway. Hello to Whitney Richards. Thank you all for watching. 2-on, 2-out. First inning, no score. Morristown West End at 7-2. Our Cyclones at 3-5. Full count now. Buckles checks some runners at second and first, and now he'll step off the bag, or rather the rubber, and looking back into the bag. How was soccer practice? Good?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah, no.
Full count. 3-2 pitch. Upstairs. Ball four. He's loading them up. So Trojans at all three locations now. He'll go to work on Malachi Isom, the second baseman now for Morristown West. So first two strikeouts and walking the next three batters, so he's got himself in a mini jam here in the first inning. We have 28 new likes. Is that good? Malachi Isom, strike one to the right-hand batting second baseman. Buckles to the belt, checks the runners. Bases loaded. foul back. He's in the hole 0-2. So Buckles, two strikes on him with the bases loaded here, trying to get out of this inning. Strikeout, walk, 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 and so they're loaded up. But he's got him on the ropes here. No balls and two strikes to the number six batter. Hello to Michael and Stevie Hutton. Thank you, Amy, for an update there. UConn leads Stetson by 28. Check swing, did he go? He did. Strikeout swinging. Nice job of Buckles to get out of the inning. Three double three strikeouts, three double C Western Supply strikeouts. No runs, no hits, no errors. They left them full. We go to the bottom of the first. Got the Cyclones coming up their first look offensively. You're watching Elizabethan Cyclone Baseball. Now this from the Jewelers.
We're talking to Joseph Taylor, one of our great sponsors here on the Tom Taylor Sports Show and Cyclone Sports. And what's going on at Ivy Hall Nursing Home?
Ivy Hall, we would love to have short-term rehab patients. If you go in for knee surgery, shoulder surgery, stuff like that, you need a little bit of rehab, please consider Ivy Hall. We have private rooms for our short-term rehab patients. We offer physical therapy, occupational therapy, speech therapy, full-time respiratory therapy. We'd love to take care of you.
Looking for help, looking for folks to work here?
Absolutely, 100%. If you want to come in, if you're a CNA, LPN, RN, you want to work in dietary, laundry, housekeeping, we would love to have you. You can go to ivyhallnursinghome.com and fill out an application. Somebody will certainly call you back if you put in an application.
Yep. So all these different folks, you take care of these different therapy programs, right?
Absolutely. We love the short-term patients. We love the long-term patients, either one. We want to take care of anybody that comes our way, for sure.
Social media,
Ivy Hall Nursing Home on Facebook. And like I said, ivyhallnursinghome.com.
There you go. One of our great sponsors, folks, love promoting them. Again, the great folks here in Elizabethan, sponsor of the Tom Taylor Sports Show and Cyclone Sports, Ivy Hall Nursing Home.
Bottom of the first inning, Buckles gets out of the jam, striking out the side. Great job by Jackson. So here we go to take our turn offensively against the Morristown West Trojan right-handed starter. Jackson Buckles, only a sophomore, and our lead man will be Bryson Rowland, our player of the game last night. Hello, Dayla Hurley. How you doing, lady? What a nice lady. Hello, Tyler Stansberry and Arliss Campbell. Patty Taylor. Gary Harrison, one of our great coaches. Basketball. What did it do? Only lost one game the whole season?
Bryson Rowland.
Here's Rowland. Rowland got two base hits last night. Our Port Travis Deli player of the game. We had lunch at Port Travis today. Oh, man, it was good. Whew. Put the roast beef and turkey on there together. Roast beef and turkey with cheese. It was awesome. Here's Rowland. First pitch, foul back. Bryson again last night in that loss to Dobbins Minute. A single in the first, a double, and scored a run in the third. And a tap back to box in the fifth. 2 for 3. It was our player of the game. He was the bright spot offensively. And a pitch that misses outside, 1-1. Rowland, Griffin, and Bugs Meadows are our first three here in the first. No score. Good eye, Rowland. 2-1. No, ma'am, I'm not necessarily kind. Well, I try to be kind. It's in the book, but it's called like I see it, Mrs. Hurley. 2-1 pitch. Shot back up the middle. That should be in for a base hit. It gets past him for right fielder. He's got one. He's got two. He's going to turn it. He's coming for three. Here comes the relay. He's going to be in with the slide. Bryson Rowland. So Rowland stands at third with a leadoff triple for the Cyclones. That's a good start for the orange and black. You're welcome. We certainly are glad we are doing that. The readers are winners. We hope to make this an annual thing. We're hoping that'll be the case for next year. Here's Griffin, Jariah, the Roadrunner. 90 feet away, run number one here. Nice piece of hitting by Rowland. He stroked it. Right fielder misplayed it. First pitch, tops it, strike one to Jariah Griffin. Rowland, Griffin, and Bugs Meadows are in the first, knocking on the door here, trailing 1-0. I'm sorry, why'd I say that? It's scoreless. We're not trailing anything. Why'd I say we're trailing? My bad. It's a scoreless ball game. Pitching. And he nubs it foul again to the plate off his left instep. Hello, Matt Gegley and Dickie Clark. Light wind blowing here. Actually, pretty good breeze. Kicking up Old Glory in straightaway center. Not a bad crowd here for a 4:30 start. Griffin walking off that foul from the instep. He's a tough bird. Get back in there and let's go, Roadrunner. Rolling a triple. He stands at third base, 90 feet away. Run number one of the ball game. Morristown West starter brings it. Slow ground ball, third base coming home. He'll play it first, and Griffin will get it by half step. Jariah Griffin, RBI, in from third. Scampers rolling, 1-0. And he darn near beat that out. I'm telling you, the guy's got some wheels. Can't wait to see him in football, which is, oh, by the way, 154 days till kickoff. Well, we're not counting. Here's Bugs Meadows. Bugs last night over 2 in the walk. Again, the night before, he helped put the clamps on Unicoi County in that 2-1 win. He came in to finish the 7th inning relief. And this one misses. Good eye for Bugs. In that 7th inning against Unicoi County, he had a tap of the box, a strikeout, and a fly out to left to end the game. Bugs pitched nice in relief. Strike call to Meadows. 1-0 Cyclones. Bottom of the first inning, one out. And a run in, bringing it. Bad handle, fouls it back. Big rip by Jariah Griffin, who's moved up in the batting order as a result of his productivity. Griffin a double last night, a double against Unicoi County. He's had two-baggers in back-to-back games. There's a slow ground ball foul, third base side for Griffin, who drove in that run. And so Bugs Meadows here now. Bugs with a two-ball, two-strike count. Trying to bounce back from a loss last night. Our kids were not happy the way things went. Meadows ground ball, third baseman backhanded. It will be a foul ball, not by much. Tried to backhand it and skipped over the bag and goes foul. Hello, Glenda Williams. How you doing, lady? Glenda and Gwen Williams. 1-0 Cyclones. First inning. 2-2 pitch. Bugs swing and a miss. Strikeout swinging. Two down. Brought some smoke in that one. Bugs went at her and didn't get it. Two down for Rhett Slagle. Also one that's been swinging a stick. Rhett is Unicoi County, 2-for-3. Last night, Slagle, 1-for-3. So here's the first pitch, towering pop, fair ball. It's a catchable ball, foul ground. No, backing out of play. Strike one. So Slagle, that was actually, that's really crazy. That's the kind of wind. That one popped up in fair ground. The wind blew it completely out of play and up into the stands. I think heard it hit the aluminum bleachers. There's a slow ground ball to the shortstop charging. He'll field. He'll throw, and he got him on the run, and that's the inning. But a run on a hit. Rollins triple on an RBI Griffin. We go to the second inning. We played one. Your Cyclones lead 1-0. You're watching Elizabethan Cyclone Baseball. Now this from Pleasant Beach Baptist Church.
This is Pastor Mark Fowler, and we want to invite you to be with us at Pleasant Beach Baptist Church sometime soon. And we're thankful for what God is doing, and we've had visitors almost every week. We have so many people that God is using His Word to accomplish a work in their life. And we want you to come. I think about our society today, and there's a lot of talk about the negative aspects and generations and what's missing and what we're going to do and how do we face this social issue and how do we face that social issue, and that is always the buzz. And if we're not careful, we talk like God doesn't have an answer. 2 Timothy chapter 3, we looked at the other night together in our church, and it reminds us that yes, in the last days there's going to be some difficult things come, dangerous times, but the antidote is always God's word. And so what we're trying to do is to provide Bible answers for today's tough questions. And we're building believers by the book. So we want your family to come. We're thankful to have a Sunday school hour and a junior church and master clubs and a youth group and all those things going on. But what we're trying to accomplish is to get the Word of God into the hearts and minds of God's people.
Number 17, Gavin.
We go to the second, 1-0 Cyclones. Gavin Mitchell, the pitcher, will lead things off for Morristown West. Cyclone baseball all season long brought to you by great sponsors like Big John's Closeouts. We appreciate them so very, very much. And all the California fix-all paints right now are 25% off while they last. Swing and a miss, strike one for Buckles. Buckles got him loaded up in the first inning and struck out to end the inning. That was awesome. Had himself in a jam. Jackson, 0-1 pitch, and jammed him, and he fought it off and fouls it off. No balls and two strikes. So Buckles had two strikeouts and walked three in a row, then struck out Malachi Isom to end the inning. So heck of a job done by Jackson Buckles, our sophomore pitcher. Hello, Bradley Johnson. Hello to Trey Avery. 0-2 pitch. Swing and a miss. A double C. Western Supply strikeout. Strikeout number four now for Buckles, and he'll go to work on Urijah Massengill. So Massengill settles in for Morristown West. We lead a 1-0 in the second. A scheduled seven. We started early because the rains are coming. Ground ball, shortstop, base hit. Pass to diving Bugs Meadows and tying run at first for Massengill, Morristown West. And here's Connor Ruse, and we'll go with Ruse.
Now batting number five, Connor Ruse.
So Ruse will be in, one out, one on here in the second inning, 1-0 Cyclones. Rolling at first, second is Whitehead, shortstop is Meadows, and the third is Rhett Slagle. Hooks behind the play catching. Fly ball, left field, Campbell, got it, great job! On a diving catch to his right by Logan Campbell. He dove, sacrificed his body, makes the catch. Great job by Logan Campbell out there. Put a star beside his name. Great defensive play. Two down. Top of the order to Jordan Watson from Morristown West. That was a big-time play. He went about four steps and just dove and stretched out his body and makes the catch. And the runner couldn't advance either. He got it back in a hurry. Watson struck out his first time up. Buckles to the belt, brings it. And it misses inside, and it's 2-0. What's Addison's last name over there running the scoreboard? Who? Holdren? Addison Holdren, Tucker says, is running the scoreboard. Braden Holly following his father's footsteps doing the PA. One on, two out, 1-0 Cyclones in the second. Foul back it out of play, count two balls and a strike. So good old East Tennessee weather, if you don't like it, it'll just hang around, it'll change. It's been 75 here on Tuesday. Yesterday, pretty pleasant night at the ballpark, really, almost a perfect night. Throw to first, he's back in safely. And now the rain, not that far away from us, it's 65 with 10-mile-an-hour wind, so it feels a little cooler than that. Pitching, missing outside to the two-out batter. Hello to Andy Peace, and almost having West Virginia. This one fouled to the backstop. This was scheduled for a 6 o'clock game. The rains are coming, and it is. You can see it on the radar. It's supposed to start raining about 6. They moved it up to 4:30. Hello, Amy Whitson. How you doing, lady? Andy's in the hills of West Virginia. Payoff pitch upstairs, ball four. They left him full in the first. They've got two on here in the second, and he'll go to work on
Charlie DeWall
now, the shortstop from Morristown West. Hello, Caleb Durant. How you doing? We had eight states represented here the other night, six last night. So they were watching, bounced up there. Hooks coming down to third to make the throw, and he'll be safe on a split second pass ball, and the runner out at second alertly gets down the line, and he will slide into third. So the tying run 90 feet away now. Runners on the corners. Two out, 1-0 is the count. Hello, T. Blevins. Upstairs, he'll let him go for an uncontested stolen base down to second. Two out, two on here in the inning. Hello, T. Blevins. Got a chance to speak in T's class the other day. Thank you, sir. I enjoyed that thoroughly. Hope they did. I guess they did. They didn't fall asleep. 2-0 pitch. Foul back, 2-1. Bat handle foul. Cyclones lead at 1-0. We're in the top of the second of a scheduled seven. Defensively, to finish the lineup, hello, Selena Stout. Got a chance to read her class the other day. Well, it was last week. She's pinch hitting from Teresa Duggar down at east side. This one fouled back, 2-2. Try Griffin in right, center field, Braden Buckles, and left field, Logan Campbell. Campbell, big time play out there a few minutes ago. Big time play. Dive to his right and made the catch. If he gets by him, he rolls to the wall. Our softball team lost last night 6-0 to Tennessee High. They're playing as we speak. Wing Deer Park in Johnson City. Soccer lost, what, 3-2 last night to Chucky Doak? We had a track meet last night, and we had tennis last night. We had a full plate. Of course, next week it's spring break. Pitching. Fouls it back. He's been a tough customer. Buckles, one of our postmen in basketball, and, of course, first baseman and pitcher here in baseball. Two balls, two strikes, two out, two on. Here in the second inning, Buckles rears back and brings it, and a ground ball back up the middle. Fielding Bugs Meadows. Fields throws and got him. Good job, Bugs, on a rocket to first. 6-3 on the putout, inning over. We go to the bottom of the second. Nice job of Meadows. We lead it 1-0. You're watching Elizabethan Cyclone Baseball. Now this from one of our great sponsors, the good folks from Physical Therapy Services.
Aaron Kaiser, rather, from Physical Therapy Services. So one of the things you guys treat is fibromyalgia. Tell me about that.
Yeah. So a lot of times the best thing that you can do for people that have fibromyalgia is get them moving and moving in a comfortable way that they feel safe and that they feel comfortable and like they have control of the situation. So we have the anti-gravity treadmill, the Alter G, where we can offload them, get them moving. We have the NuCEP, which they like because they're not full weight bearing. They can adjust that. And overall, just patient education, teaching them how to move and move in that pain-free or that more comfortable way for them.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Good stuff. They offer a lot of services, of physical therapy services. Mm-hmm. How do we find you on social media?
Facebook. We have an ortho clinic that has a Facebook page and then a pediatric clinic that has a Facebook page.
They've been with us since day one. Proud sponsors. I love promoting these folks. Again, Dr. Danny, Dr. Justin Smith, Dr. Sylvester, Dr. Aaron, and all the other great folks, sponsors of the Tom Taylor Sports Show and Cyclone Sports Physical Therapy Services.
We go to the bottom of the second inning. Hello, Hannah Slagle. How you doing, lady? I met you. You work at Eastside Elementary. Downstairs, strike call to J.D. Hooks to start the inning. Hello to Michael Kitchens. Hello to Gay Whitson. We're in the second. Cyclones lead at 1-0. Hooks, Whitehead, and Buckles here in the Cyclone second. Mitchell, ground ball right back to him. Gavin Mitchell. Lollipop throw to first. 1-3 in the put out. One away. Hooks retired to start the second for the Cyclones. Here's Justin Whitehead.
Now batting number four, Justin Whitehead.
So I made a new friend out at Eastside. It was Miss Slagle. One out is Whitehead. Whitehead a single last night and drove in a run. First pitch, fly ball. Could be trouble. Anything out here today with the winds kind of goofy and a catch made by the right fielder. Two down now. Hello, J.C. Shell, one of our basketballers and volleyballers, and she does about everything. Hello, Mikey Blevins. Two out of the inning. It's 1-0 Cyclones. Here is Braden Buckles, the center fielder. We've had some good outfielders out here since I've been calling these games, but tell you what, we got a pretty rock-solid defensive outfield again this year. Griffin in right, Logan Campbell in left, and Buckles in center. They can cover a lot of real estate out there. 0-1 pitch, bad handle foul, back it out of play, and he's in a hole at 0-2. But continues, Logan Campbell's on deck here. Hello, Rick Ranson, you're representing Florida. Florida's watching down in Pensacola. Appreciate you, sir. 1-0 in the second. Good ball game here already. Threatening skies. This one outside. Good eye, Buckles. If it continues, we said Campbell on deck. Gavin Mitchell brings it. Shoots it in the right field. Does it hang up? And it does. A 1-2-3 inning for Morristown West. We played two. We go to the third. Cyclones lead 1-0. You're watching Elizabethan Cyclone Baseball.
Folks in Port Travis Deli, it's football time in Tennessee, as the late John Ward said. So Friday night, going to the ball game, come by and get your sandwiches. Tell us how you can help us.
Hey, just give us a call, 543-6128, and tell us what you like. White dark bread, we've got ham, turkey, roast beef, corned beef, pastrami, make a good steak sandwich. You want some chicken salad, some pickles and eggs, you know, if you just want a snack. Some people just like to snack at the ball game, don't really want to eat a big meal. We can take care of that for you. We got chips and drinks if you want to pack your cooler or whatever. Got anything you need?
Yep, 543-6128 is what you call, or the number you call, and he'll have it ready for you. So if you're heading to the game, how much time should we allow you to get them ready?
Usually about 10 to 15 minutes is a pretty good time.
Yep, 10 or 15 minutes.
About 10 to 15 minutes, we'll take care of you.
Yep, ready to go. 543-6128. Again, it will be an excellent, excellent opportunity to come by here and get some great food.
Yep. Love to serve you.
Love to serve you, absolutely. Yep. How do you find us on social media?
We got a Facebook page. You can look us up there, leave us some feedback, give us a like.
Yep. Friday night football, Saturday football, whenever you need sandwiches, here's the place to come. Port Draft Deli, 543-6128, one of our great sponsors here on Cyclone Sports and the Tom Taylor Sports Show. We go to the third inning, 1-0 Cyclones. Thanks for being with us. Yours truly, Tom Taylor, along with Tucker Taylor running the camera. Ain't no kin, but
so they'll all get a gift. Thank you very much.
Now batting number 10, Bryson Shepherd.
Here's Bryson Shepherd. Again, he's not kin, but I think the world of this young man. Pitch is strike called. Start the third inning for Bryson Shepherd. He walked his first time up. Speaking of my cameraman, Tucker Taylor. 0-1 pitch. Swing and a miss. 0-2. Buckles with four punch outs in the game. 1-0 Cyclones in the third. As I've said, if you say something bad about Tucker, you're going to have to come through me. That's my buddy. Swing and a miss. Double C, Western Supply strikeout. Punch out number five now for Buckles. And
number four, Cody Blair.
One away for Cody Blair. He walked his first time up. So Buckles, hello, K-Scaff. And Batsy Lyons. Buckles struck out three in the first, obviously the side. He got him a punch out. In the second, he strikes out the leadoff man here in the third. 1-0 Cyclones. Pulled the string on him, swing and a miss. Only a 10th grader, a big one. He can bring it. There's a ground ball, hit right on the screws to Slagle. Fields, throws, got him, two down. Rep made it look easy down at third. That's a sharply hit baseball, and Rep made it look easy, 5-3, with Roland taking the throw, two away.
Batting number 14, Paxton
Seal. After today, our next broadcast, next week is spring break, so everybody's gone. Then we'll come back on the 1st on that Monday for the Folds of Honor softball game. Just Happy Valley. Downstairs, ball one. Seal walked his first time up. So the Folds of Honor will be what we'll do on April the 1st. Got a big week of baseball then. This one popped up and out of play. fouled back. O-1 pitch, another foul back. Case in point, we'll start Hiller, Richard Whitson. I'm not saying anything about Tucker. That'd be Pete Taylor, says I ain't saying nothing about him. You know Pete Taylor?
Yeah, my grandfather.
I know, he's watching. Swing and a miss. Strikeout swing in Jackson Buckles is strong as a garlic milkshake. That's good stuff there. We'll take a break. We'll be right back. We come back for the bottom of the third. Cyclones lead 1-0.
At Northeast Community Credit Union, we know the importance of taking care of your family and building our community. Are you remodeling your home, trading cars for your next road trip, or maybe you're considering an in-ground pool or a boat for the lake? Our loans are easy, fast, and convenient with the lowest payments around. Act now before rates go up. Apply online at bmicu.org, call us, or come see us in Elizabethan, Johnson City, or Rome Mountain. We have the loan you need.
We go to the bottom of the third. Cyclones bring up Logan Campbell, Jack Blevins, and the top of the order, Bryson Rowland.
Leading off the bottom of the third, number one, Logan Campbell.
Campbell, big defensive play already in this baseball game. He was 0 for 2 last night with a walk and a ground out. Making the point about our schedule after the spring break, we've got games on Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday. There's a base hit to left field on the first pitch by Logan Campbell. Takes a big turn. And he'll put on the brakes and get back into first with a leadoff single. Nice piece of hitting by Campbell. Base hit number 2 for the Cyclones. And a 1-0 lead is Jack Blevins' turn here. So we'll come back on the first and bring you the Folds of Honor game, our softball team. So here's Jack Blevins DHing for the pitcher, Jackson Buckles. Hello, Greg Hyder. Hello, Mike Jensen. 1-0 Cyclones in the home half of the third with scheduled 7. The radar covered in rain, it's coming. We should get this thing in. He squares the butt. It's a fair ball out in front of the plate. Catcher throws and got him. Nice job, Blevins. Textbook dropped it into the artificial turf, and it just kind of did a squeegee and spun around on the top spin. He almost beat that out. Sack bunt. Nice job by Blevins. That was perfect. 2-3 on the put out. One away. Top of the order. Moving down to second is where he wanted Logan Campbell. Here's Bryson Rowland. He tripled his first time up. So Mitchell working from the stretch, second time through on the starter. See what we can do with him. We lead 1-0. Swing and a miss, Rowland. Rowland, our player of the game last night, got him a free Porch Arabs deli sandwich of choice. I was there today. Man, oh man, oh man, was it good. Goodness gracious. They don't scrimp when you get a sandwich from Poor Trav's Deli. 0-1 pitch. Swing and a miss. 0-2. Hello, Josh Wallen. Saw my buddy JW earlier today. He's going to take care of me. Get me some new tars on my machine. My buddy Wallen. Love him. He's a good man. Tom brother. Yep, we're brothers in Christ. You better believe it. 0-2 pitch. They go back to throw in behind him, and then there's Campbell. Got back in safely. One nothing Cyclones, home half of the third here. One out, one on. Got him in second. See if Rowland can drive him around. He tripled his first time up. Mitchell to the belt for Morristown West. Inside and tight. Good eye by Rice and Rowland. On deck will be Jerry Griffin. Hello, Nick McNeil. How you doing, sir? I hope you got the batting cage. Whew, made me a nervous wreck. Church the other night. Try to see if you get a batting cage. 1-2 pitch, swing and a miss. Big rip, big smoking fastball by Mitchell. Two down. It's his second strikeout of the ball game. Jackson Buckles got six. Two out of the inning here in the third for Jeriah Griffin. Ground ball to third, plating, rolling back in the first with an RBI for Jeriah. Runner at second, see if we can drive him in here. We lead 1-0 in the third. First pitch fouled off the face mask of the catcher, strike one. Rain today, rain tomorrow. Rain tonight, I should say, rain tomorrow. Wind's kicking up here at the ballpark. Inside and tight, and it's a strike call, 1-1. Hello, Sherry Walsh. How you doing, lady? Nick says, no. Nope, we ain't got one yet. That's still a no. So I'll go to bat for you, son. I'll talk her into it. 0-2 pitch upstairs. Throw to third. High throw. He's in with a stolen base. Running on the swing and a miss by Griffin and down to third with a stolen base, Logan Campbell. 90 feet away now. So we can get him around. 1-2 pitch, and this one hit him. Hit batsman and Jeriah will run to first. We got him on the corners now for Bugs Meadows.
Now batting number 29, Bugs Meadows.
So what we can do here now, be a good time for a little. Coach will walk out to talk to his starting pitcher and his catcher. Again, Cyclone Baseball brought to you by great folks like Pleasant Beach Baptist Church. Will be at the church house for Palm Sunday. And if you don't have a church home, we would love for you to come visit with us. We have a lot of visitors and folks joining. It's doing well. We enjoy it thoroughly at Pleasant Beach Baptist Church. Next Sunday's the cantata, Christmas cantata, Christmas cantata, Easter cantata at Pleasant Beach, as it will be at most churches, I would assume. Got him on the corners to see what Bugs can do here. Pitch is outside, ball one after meeting the mound. Third inning, 1-0 Cyclones trying to add to this lead. We lost to them earlier in the season down to Morristown, 5-1, Troy. Trying to avenge that loss. Mitchell brings it. Bugs inside and tight. Bows him back, and it's 2-0. Cleanup batter, Red Slagle on deck here in the third inning of a scheduled seven. Throw to first. Back in. Jeriah Griffin. He's got that sliding glove on his right hand, an arm, that bright orange sliding glove. He's got the wheels. Campbell the third's got the wheels. Let's see what Bugs can do. Popped him up. Bad handle come back our way, and it's back it out of play. Hello, Gary White. How you doing, sir? Third inning, 1-0 Cyclones, 2-1, 2-out. Trying to add to it. Catcher will go out and talk. Cody Blair will talk to his pitcher here. See, make sure they're up to snuff on the signals. Bugs at a 2-ball, 1-strike count here. Given the fact there's rain on the radar and coming our way, they're trying to speed this thing up, make this a complete game. Got to get to the fifth to make it happen. We're in the third. Cyclones lead 1-0. Got him on the corners now. Two out for Bugs. Let's see what he can do after the meeting of the catcher and the pitcher. See if they will give him something he can turn on. Mitchell throws the first. Now throws back to third. And all hands are safe. He bluffed a throw to first and wheeled and threw it to third. And He's back in safely. That was a nice move by Mitchell. Campbell off the bag at third. Bugs bounced up there. Good eye, Meadows. 3-1 now. Single Campbell, sack bunt, Blevins to get him down to first, or I'm sorry, down to second. Roland strikes out swinging, drag out hit, and here we are with Bugs. Griffin going down to second, it's strike two, nope, ball four. We'll take it, base is loaded. Loaded up for Rhett Slagle, two out here. Hello, Kelly Lewis, how are you? See what Red can do here. Got him loaded. Here's your cleanup batter. Here's who you want up there in a run-producing situation. Brings it. Slagle, fastball, strike call. Nice pitch. Hello, Adam Copeland. How you doing, sir? Bases jammed. Third inning. We lead 1-0. Two out of the inning for Red Slagle, your cleanup batter. Gets Morristown West. Brings it. Fly ball, well tagged. Out in left field. Going to go back, and they're not going to get it. Off the top of the wall. One run scores. Two run scores. Three run scores. Rhett Slagle delivers. Three run double for Slagle. He hammered that way off the wall, then deep left center field. For a three run double for Rhett Slagle. He teed off on that bad boy. Scoring Logan Campbell, scoring Jariah Griffin, scoring Bugs Meadows, all running with two men out. And Slagle drives it deep and long, and it's a 4-0 ball game. Here is J.D. Hooks. Wow, bases clearing double for Rhett Slagle. That was pretty. Hello, Shannon Stanley. Hello, Seth Snyder. Hooks. Fastball down and away. Slagle out at second. Bases clearing two-bagger. 4-0 Elizabethan. That's how you do it right there. That was a sweet swinging piece of hitting. And it's downstairs. Good eye to Hooks. On deck is Justin Whitehead. Three runs, two hits here in the inning for Elizabethan, leading 4-0 now in the third. Ground ball, shortstop, field, sidearms it, got him, inning over. Big inning for the orange and black. Three runs on a couple of base hits, we leave him at. We played three. We go to the fourth inning, your Cyclones lead it. 4-0, you're watching Elizabethan Cyclone Baseball.
It's a three-story antique mall, huge. We have like over 50,000 square feet and over 50 different vendors. All kind of with their own little niche. It sort of feels like walking back into the past.
Amen.
You can see things from all decades. We have glassware and kitchen things, and then we also have tools and jars and bottles and lots of sports memorabilia. Even the local Elizabethan, some of the local guys who were here, Jason Witten, there's some of his cards and different items in there as well.
Hours are open at Duck Crossing?
We're open 11 to 5:30 Monday through Friday, and then 10 to 6 on Saturdays. We stay open later whenever they have the car shows on Saturday nights or for the first Friday events.
Yep. Social media, how do we find you?
We are on Facebook Duck Crossing Elizabethan, and then on Instagram we are Duck Crossing Antiques.
Yep. One of our sponsors of Cyclone Sports, got to check them out. I buy stuff there all the time. Misty Counts and the good folks at Duck Crossing Antique Mall in downtown Elizabethan. We go to the fourth inning. Cyclones lead at 4-0 for Elizabethan so far in the ballgame. Four runs on three hits. They've left one. And for Morristown West, no runs on one hit. They've stranded five. Six strikeouts under his belt. Jackson Buckles goes to work on 6, 7, and 8 in the Morristown West lineup. Leading off was Malachi Isom. Isom struck out at the end of the first inning. Buckles three in the first. He struck out the side. One strikeout in the second and two more last inning. Inching towards a complete game here with the weather threatening. And it's a pitch that misses downstairs, ball one to Isom. Hello, Peggy Jones and Vista Clark and Timmy and Stephanie Garland. Thank you all so much. Devin Whitehead. Strike call, one and one. Shannon Stanley, Adam Copeland. We say hello to everybody up to this point. Love saying hello to you all. 1-1 pitch. Upstairs, around the eyes, 2-1. Shot back up the middle. Solid hit into the charging center fielder, Braden Buckles, and a leadoff single for Malachi Isom. Base hit number two of the ball game now for the Trojans, and here is the pitcher, Gavin Mitchell. Struck out his only plate appearance back in the second. Top of the fourth, Cyclones lead at 4-0. Buckles checks him at first, Roland holds him on. Bunts, first base side, pretty good one. Buckles the field, barehanded underhand toss to Roland. Good job of the pitcher on our side and a nice bump by their pitcher. 1-3 on the sacrifice bunt down to second. Goal accomplished for Morristown West. Puts him in scoring position for Urijah Massengill. Has the only other ball hit of the ball game, I should say. A single back in the second inning. 4-0 Cyclones in the third here. I'm sorry, in the fourth here. Swing and a miss. Took a big rip, didn't get it. Took something off that one. So the buzz continues up in Lexington about getting rid of John Calipari. A $33 million buyout to get rid of him. I would think that would prevent that from happening, but you never know. This misses 1-1. Thinking about March Madness and laid another egg from Lexington. 1-1 pitch. Ground ball. It's a fair ball to Slagle at third. Looks him back to second throw. Got him. Runner comes on down to third. Two down. Reds had a couple of hot shots down to thirds. Played them perfectly. Two away. Runner comes on down to third after the throw across the diamond, and it's Connor Ruse's turn to the plate.
Now batting number five, Connor Ruse.
Buckles brings it. Upstairs around the eyes, ball one. Top of the fourth, 4-0 Cyclones. Pop infield. Who's got it? Who wants it? And Roland's got it. We go to the bottom of the fourth. 4-0 Cyclones. Here's Big John's closeout.
Loyal. Buy local. He's up against the big boy chains. We know that. Why Big John's closeouts? What do you feel like separates you from the chains?
Well, I think there's a number of factors I think that go into that. Number one, we're local folks. We shop with you all in other places. We go to church with you. We're involved in civic organizations with you. What money you spend here stays here. You know, it goes to support the payroll. And, of course, local taxes, as far as that goes, it also supports a lot of nonprofits as well as sports teams, little leagues, softball, all kind of different things we try to support. We support all the high schools, both city and county, you know, either through, fence signs or gymnasium signs or whatever with yearbooks and the whole bit. So, you know, once you're spending local, is staying local. And also we believe, you know, customer service. You know, I came up through the Patey Lumber Company ranks from many years ago. 1977 is when I started. And if you didn't get up and wait on people, or you didn't speak to people, or you didn't try to help people, you wouldn't go to stick around very long. So you learned, you know, that it was important not only to try to just ask people, but to listen, find out what they're trying to do, find out ways that you can help them as far as that goes. And so all that's very important to us.
There you go, folks. Be loyal, buy local, support them. Big John's Closeouts here in downtown Elizabeth with the hammer high prices. Great sponsor of the Tom Bailey Sports Show and Elizabethan Cyclone Sports, Big John's Closeouts. Back at Northeast Community Credit Union Ballpark, Justin White had ground ball out behind second, and the throw pulled the first baseman off the bag, and he's safe at first base. You have to credit them with an error on that one, a throw by the shortstop. First error of the ball game. Hello, Ernie Berry. Hello to Aaron Shelby. Hello to somebody asked me if I do T.A. Duggar. Yeah, we're going to try. We got a lot of baseball and from the high school level and the softball, but we'll see. Would love to if time would permit it, but a lot of times they play on the same days as the varsity does here on the high school level. So we'll see. I guess wait and see. Hello, Ernie. Thank you, sir. Runner at first. Here is Braden Buckles. Throw to first. Back in diving. So White hit on with an E6. Throw pulled to first baseman off the bag. It was a ground ball that should have been ruled an out for sure. Bunts it. First base side. A foul ball. Buckles flat out to right to end the second inning. Run the fourth. Cyclones lead at 4-0. And the big blow, a bases clearing three-run double by Rhett Slagle. Brings it. Swing and a miss. Throw back to first to double him up, and there's one away. Strikeout swinging number three of the game. For Mitchell, the starter for Morristown West. Here's Campbell, single, and it came around to score. He was on base when Slagle hit the halfway up the wall, deep left center field, that bases clearing double. So Campbell one for one. Hello, Terry McPeak, how you doing? Foul back. Home half of the fourth, Cyclones lead it 4-0. Skies are threatening and clouds are thickening, particularly back towards Johnson City, the direction of the rain. So far, so good. Hello, Lana Snyder. How you doing, lady? Mitchell to the belt. The starter from Morristown West checks him at second, or rather at first, low ground ball. Foul, Campbell. He topped it and he knew it. Man, I'd like to have that one back. One out, one on. Fourth inning, we're up four. One of our great sponsors all season long, the Coffee Company. Oh, me, oh, my. That homemade coconut cream pie will set you free. Check swing, bad handle foul to the backstop, kind of delayed swing. What do they have? I'm glad you asked. Goodness gracious, downtown Elizabethan, they're awesome. You ever been there? Yeah. Good. 0-2 pitch outside, 1-2. Espressos, lattes, cappuccinos, smoothies, chai teas. Have the sugar-free flavors. Here's another throw to first. Paying a lot of attention to him. Sugar-free vanilla, caramel, hazelnut, white chocolate, peppermint, and raspberry coffee by the pound at the Coffee Company. This one down there, good block by Cody Blair, the Morristown West catcher. They've got a blend they make called Jamaican Me Crazy. I love that. I'm not a coffee connoisseur per se, but they say it is awesome. Appalachian Morning's one of the big favorites, too. They sell a lot of that. This one is a chopper foul, first base side. The Coffee Company. Here in Elizabeth and in the TBC, the turkey, bacon, and cheddar. Whew. Good stuff. Thank you, Frankie, and Frankie Bailey, the folks of the Coffee Company, a great sponsor here of the ball games. 2-2 pitch outside of the backstop. Pass ball down to second will scamper Justin Whitehead. 1 out, one on to the fourth. We lead it 4-0. Teachers today take a big sigh of relief. They get a week off for spring break, as do the kids. Payoff pitch and a chop foul at the plate by Logan Campbell. 4-0 Cyclones, fourth inning.
For your tickets out for tonight's Dash for Cash from Elizabethton Federal, the lucky contestant is number 295. Last three digits, 295.
Payoff pitch to Campbell. Check swing. A foul ball stays alive. 3-2. For a Friday afternoon 4:30 start, not a bad crowd down here, really. So a lot more students are coming out, which I think is great. As we begin spring break, Mitchell checks it, brings it. Outside ball four. Campbell works him to a one-out walk. Cyclones at second and first with one away in the fourth. Here's Jack Blevins, the DH, for the pitcher Jackson Buckles. Hello to Mrs. Minton. Dr. J's better half, Mrs. Minton. Watching the broadcast, Mitchell brings it. First pitch is a strike call. Nice one. Big breaking pitch. Inning has gone E6. Shortstop on the throw to Justin Whitehead. Got him at first. Pitches. Ground ball. A rope to third base. He knocks it down. Steps on the bag for one. And that's the one they wanted. The lead man. Fielder's choice. Five unassisted in the book. Third baseman steps on the bag to get coming down from second, Justin Whitehead for out number two. Top of the order for Roland. A triple to start the game and a strikeout. He's 1-for-2. We need a home run to hit the cycle here. We've had a triple, a double, and a single here. Mitchell brings. Roland takes. Off speed downstairs. Ball one. Hello, Steve Franklin. Mrs. Minton says, go Cyclones. You got it. 4-0, Betsy, fourth inning. Lights have popped on here at the ballpark. Pitches. Ground ball. Base into the right field. Rounding third. He gets the green light. Here comes the play. The plate. He'll be up the line for the throw, and Campbell's in. An RBI for Bryson Rowland, and it's 5-0. Campbell scores. Stopping down at third.
Now batting number 10, Jariah Griffin.
So rolling out at second with an RBI. Here's Jariah, hit batsman and a ground out to third. Runners at second and third. Here's one foul ball. Jack Blevins down to third. So Blevins, 90 feet away, with run number six, 5-0 Cyclones. Inside, hunkered him down to Jariah Griffin. He got hit the first time up. So RBI for Bryson Rowland. All the runs earned today. We like that. 1-1 pitch. It means we're swinging the sticks. Fly ball, left field, down the left field line, and back it out of play. He drove it way down the left field line. Big rip by Griffin, but the Roadrunner will come back and pick up his aluminum stick with a one ball, two strike count on him. The wind has died down right now, which is a good thing. Bottom of the fourth, Cyclones lead 5-0. Upstairs, good eye by Jariah Griffin. Told you, big time player for our football team. In 154 days, we'll have Science Hill up the street here at Citizens Bank Stadium. Here before you know it. Foul back, big rip again by Jariah Griffin. Stepped into that one. If it continues, Bugs Meadows on deck. Batter number six here in the inning for Elizabethan. Hello, Steve Franklin. How you doing, sir? Mitchell brings it for Morristown West, and a swing and a miss. Pull the string on him. Strikeout swing inning over, but the Cyclones pick up a run. On one hit, we've played four innings of baseball. Elizabethan leads it 5-0. We'll be back after this. You're watching Elizabethan Cyclone Baseball.
Cyclone Sports and the Tom Bennett Sports Show. What all do you have here at the jeweler's bench?
So we carry an assortment of items. We've got Watchwise, G-Shock, Bearing, Citizens, Pearlwise. We do Imperial Pearl. I get some from a company called AGI, really great company. Diamonds, we do all kinds from Shaw Diamonds. We have lab-grown diamonds, Pandora. Do carry Classic Imports, which is sterling silver items. And then Sterling Reputation, that's sterling silver items. Piaro is sterling silver, diamond, 14-karat, yellow gold. Spido watch bands, stuff from Equity Diamonds, just a wider range.
Jewelry repair, do a lot of that, of course. And jewelry cleaning, all that available here again as we are here at the jeweler's bench. And so social media, how do we find you?
So Facebook and Instagram. And then website is jewelersbenchtn.com.
One of our great sponsors, Cyclone Sports, the Tom Bennett Sports Show, the great folks at the jeweler's bench.
Now batting number three, Jordan Watson.
Four in the book. Cyclones lead at 5-0. Thanks for being with us. Yours truly, Tom Taylor, along with Tucker Taylor running the camera. Top of the order, here's Jordan Watson. 1, 2, and 3 here in the fifth inning. Cyclones lead 5-0 in a scheduled 7. Wall on a walk and a strikeout. He's 0-for-1. Buckles has struck out 6 and given up only 2 hits in the ballgame, 2 singles, and that's been it. So Jackson Buckles, a big 10th grader, bringing it. 2-0 pitch. Outside, ball 3, 3-0. Hello, Jeremy Wallen. How you doing, sir? 3-0. And a strike called all the way, 3-1. Cyclone Baseball being brought to you all season long by folks like Big Dan's Barbecue. Ooh, man. This one misses outside, ball 4. Lead walk for Morristown West here in the fifth inning. Here's Charlie DeWald, the shortstop. He's 0-for-2, a strikeout and a ground out to short. So Buckles leans in, gets his side. He'll go to work on the right-hand batting shortstop. Fouls it back. Morristown West on the season with a record of 7-2. Cyclones at 3-5. Buckles leans in, gets it again. Brings it. Downstairs, good block. Hooks down to second. May have a play, and nope, it skips on in past Meadows, and it'll be a chance for him to come on down to third. Here comes the throw. It's a high throw off the hand, off the glove of Slagle. A runner cannot advance, so stolen base. Hello, Sandra Perkins. How you doing, lady? So Watson down at third. 1-1 pitch. Fly ball pretty well tagged down to the gap in left center field. On his horse, he's going to get to it. And Buckles does. He tracks it down. Sacrifice Fly run in. It's 5-1. Buckles did a great job. Ran a long way. Raiden to haul that down in deep left center field. Nice play to haul it in. One away. But the Sac Fly runner tags.
Now batting number 10, Bryson Shepard.
5-1 Cyclones now in the fifth inning. One out for Bryson Shepard. A walk and a strikeout. Buckles with six punch outs of the ball game. Jackson, 1-0 pitch, foul back. Your mother's watching. He just shook his head. See what? Why didn't she just stay if she's going to watch? Well, there you go. Well, she probably wanted to see your dad. 1-2 pitch downstairs, 2-2. You what? Oh. Two balls and two strikes to the one-out batter. Swing and a miss. A double C Western Supply strikeout number 7 for Jackson Buckles. Two out of the Morristown West fifth inning, and he'll go to work on Cody Blair, the cleanup batter, walking a ground out to third. Tell him to hush. There we go. We're communicating. The clouds are getting darker and thicker above us here. This one's almost a complete game no matter what happens. 5-1 Cyclones, fifth inning. Downstairs. Can't remember the rule now. Is it complete five? It's changed. It goes back and forth. Either 4.5 or 5 innings is a complete game. We're an out away from being 4.5 and 4 outs away from being complete 5. This one downstairs. Hook's catching. First is Roland. Second is Whitehead, rather. Shortstop is Meadows, and a third is Slagle. Taking all the way. Strike call. 3-1. Left field is Campbell. Center field is Buckles, and right field, Dry Griffin. Swing and a miss up around the eyes. Full count now. Payoff pitch. Swing and a miss. Double C, Western Supply strikeout again. And Jackson Buckles is throwing BB. He's got 8 strikeouts now here in the ballgame. That's the fifth inning for Morristown West. We go to the bottom of the inning. Cyclones lead at 5-1. You're watching Elizabethan Cyclone Baseball. Now this from Food City.
Girl Mayani. A little thing that I love about the Chick-fil-A Cobb salad is the chicken, literally the nuggets, they smack. When you put those nuggets in the salad, it just brings the salad to life. I'll give it a 10 out of 10.
Hi, I'm Jasmine. And a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A market salad is that the chicken is super juicy and the apples can be a little tangy, also a little sweet as well. So there's just a ton of different flavors. It's just so good.
New man on the mound for Morristown West to start the fifth inning. It's Jordan Watson, the center fielder, comes in to pitch, and Mitchell, the starter, goes out there to just make a swamp. And he'll go to work on the likes of Bugs Meadows, Rhett Slagle, and J.D. Hooks. It is getting cooler out here, there's no question. The old ballpark. Cooler temperatures usually means there's rain in the offing, and there is on the radar. 5-1 Cyclones. Rolling on that leadoff spot, 2-for-3 of the triple and an RBI single. Dry Griffin is an RBI, and that's two hole. You have The big blow, the bases clearing, three-run double off the halfway up the left center field wall by Red Slagle back in the third. That's been the biggie. And all five runs have been earned tonight by the Cyclones, which is a good thing. It means we're driving the baseball. Down to second goes the throw, and here we go for the Cyclone fifth. Let off by Bugs Meadows. Bugs a strikeout on a walk and a run scored. Hello, Thomas Cobalt. He was on base when Slagle hammered that fastball halfway up the wall, deep left center field. So Watson, the southpaw, first pitch, swing and a miss to start the fifth inning. When's your next soccer match? Downstairs, 1-1. Next week? 1-1 pitch. Hello, Josh Hall. Upstairs, around the eyes, 2-1. Oh, you're off next weekend. Okay, spring break. Good. Should be off. 2-1 pitch. Ground ball, Meadows. Shortstop in the hole, has to hurry. Throws and pulled him off the bag. Safe! First base infield hit, Bugs Meadows. Pulled him off the bag, backhanded deep in the hole to his right. The shortstop righted and threw, and it's base hit number five for the Cyclones here. Here's Red Slagle. He's had the big blow, the big three-run bases clearing double. So Bugs Meadows has a Curtis runner at first. Andrew Blevins running at first now for the Cyclones. Watson brings it. Slagle upstairs to the backstop it goes. Down to second goes Blevins. In scoring position now for Red Slagle. Watson checks him out at second. Brings it. And a foul back. Fifth inning, 5-1 Cyclones here. Thanks for being with us wherever you may be. We're right here enjoying our broadcast. Encourage you to go to collinsandcompany.info and check out those auctions we got going on. Downstairs, Good Eye by Slagle. Got reductions in pricing in some of the homes they've got for sale. They've got some new listings. They got an auction you can be bidding on right now, a bunch of antique items. By simply going to collinsandcompany.info. One of our great sponsors of Cyclone Baseball. Check swing foul back by Slagle, and it's a two-ball, one-strike count. Fifth inning, 5-1 Cyclones. Morristown West. Again, West came in at 7-2. We're 3-5. And a young baseball team. We keep saying that, but it's true. Growing up every time, of course. Only three seniors on the team. 2-2 pitch to Slagle. And a strike three called, froze him. Nice, crafty throw by Watson. The southpaw from Morristown West. Fourth strikeout of the ballgame. The first for Watson in relief here in this inning of the starter Gavin Mitchell. One out, one on the fifth. We're up 5-1. Here's J.D. Hooks. He's 0-2. A tap the box and a ground out to shortstop. Watson brings it. That's a fly ball well tagged to left field. Going back about six steps. Camps under it. The edge of the warning track makes the catch. Two down. Two away for Hooks and the Cyclones. Here's Justin Whitehead. Hello to Rick Presnell. Hello to John Hutchins. Tell you what, one of the coolest things this week. Two things jump out of me. Hello, Chris Green. How you doing? Was a ribbon cutting of the night when Unicoi County was here, and we gave Deb Googe a jersey with 37 on it for the number of years she's been in our system. She's retiring. Fastball, misses ball one. That was a pretty cool thing. And then I thought this was really neat. The Unicoi County Library flooded earlier in the year, lost a lot of books due to water damage, and our kids at Elizabethan High School took up a collection and gave the Unicoi County strike called 1-1. Unicoi County Library a check for $589 that our student body generated and gave. Is that not cool? That is a really cool gesture. Proud of these kids at EHS. 1-1 pitch upstairs, but a strike two called. 1-2. Hello to Brian Russell. 1-1, 2-out, 5th inning. We lead 5-1 over Morristown West. Move this one up because of the rain, and I don't think we're going to miss it. I think the forecast is going to be right there. 1-2 pitch. Outside, good eye, Whitehead, 2-2. If it continues, Braden Buckles on deck. Baseball team takes to South Carolina next week. So does our softball team. Get to go play in the surf and play baseball and softball next week. Whitehead, did he go? He did not, but he should have. Check swing gone. Third inning, or third out, I should say, in the fifth inning. We're at a complete ball game now. We played five. We'll come back for the sixth inning. Cyclones lead it 5-1. You're watching Elizabethan Cyclone Baseball. Now this from one of our great sponsors, Pleasant Beach Baptist Church.
This is Pastor Fowler, Pleasant Beach Baptist Church in Elizabethan, and we'd love to have you come be with us. You and your family be with us on Sunday. I'm standing here in the lobby at our visitor's table, our welcome table, and there's packets made up with tells you a little more about the church and get acquainted card, and then also a mug and some things in there for you to take with you to remind you to pray for us. And we've got a place for you and your family. We want you to come. Our goal is for you to know the Lord Jesus Christ as your Savior. But beyond that, to find your purpose and contentment in life of knowing Him, walking with Him, and serving Him each day. And so we want you and your family to come be with us Sunday morning, Sunday night, or Wednesday night. We're looking forward to seeing you soon. You can find a little more information about us online at PleasantBeachBaptist.com.
We go to the sixth inning. Cyclones lead at 5-1. New man on the mound, Bugs Meadows, a sidearmer in relief of Jackson Buckles tonight, who pitched very, very well. How good did he pitch? Well, Jackson Buckles today was a two-hit shutout and struck out eight. Buckles struck out eight, allowed two hits, a single in the second and a single in the fourth, and that was it. Excellent performance by Jackson Buckles, and we needed it from the sophomore. Hello, Joel Etter, Eugene Bird. So it's Morristown West turn in the sixth inning. It's 5, 6, and 7. Against Bugs Meadows, he came in to shut the door on Unicoi County on Tuesday night, won that game 2-1. We'll get rid of this right here. Just hit this. I did.
Now up number 14, Braxton Seal.
Hello, Eugene Bird. Hello to Brian Witcher, Wayne Price, Kelly Francis. Here's Braxton Seal walking a strikeout against Buckles. Buckles stands to get the W here in this one. Swing and a miss. Bugs will waste no time up there. He gets that ball right back at you. Sixth inning, we lead 5-1 here. Meadows brings it. Inside a tied 1-1. Want to update those for me, sir? These right here. Strike called. Meadows gets it, brings it, gets it, brings it. Wastes no time. Morristown West been held to two base hits. Meadows, 1-2. Ground ball right back off his glove. Whitehead will field it on the ricochet and pump and got him. Nice job. Check that. It's Jack Blevins at second. One down. Nice job of Blevins on the ricochet off the glove of Bugs Meadows, and it's 4-3 on the putout. Almost go 1-4-3 on the ricochet, but we'll go 4-3, one away for Malachi Isom. He has one of the base hits in the game. There you go. Meadows brings it, and it's a pitch downstairs and away ball one. Hello, Samuel Barnett. Bugs with that left foot facing the third base foul line, shielding the ball from the batter. 2-0, Bugs right back. So let's go. I'm ready to roll here. Hello, Drew Williams. Ground ball. Two hops and through the wickets to Blevins into right field. E4. Runner on here in the sixth inning. Here's Gavin Mitchell.
Number 17, Gavin Mitchell.
Mitchell, the pitcher. Strikeout on a sacrifice bunt. He's 0-1. Top of the sixth of a scheduled seven. Cyclones lead 5-1 here. Bringing it. Taking it. Letter high. Misses ball one. We'll call balk on Bugs Meadows, and down to second will go Malachi Isom. Meadows brings it. Throws it behind him and down to third. And the pass ball will come. He threw it behind him. It's a wild pitch. So are these finals? Okay. UConn. Is that a five? UConn blows out Stetson 91-52. Clemson 21-point win over New Mexico. Marquette beats Western Kentucky, so yeah, Yale and Auburn going on, and Colorado and Florida going on. Foul tip, strike, 2-1. You've got Nebraska, Texas A&M coming up, so we'll keep you posted. What's going on with March Madness? 2-1 pitch downstairs, ball three. Runner third, it's 5-1 Cyclones in the top of the sixth. Meadows brings it. Ground ball. Shortstop. Run will score. Fields. Throws. Got him. Nice job. Red Slagle, shortstop now. Makes another put out. Nice. Whitehead moves down to third. Blevins is at second. At first is rolling. There's two down to the inning.
Now batting number seven, Uriah Marshall.
Here's Massengale. Single and two tries today. One of the two base hits in the ball game for Morristown West. Jackson Buckles on, 8 strikeout, 2-hit performance tonight on the mound. Meadows there in his replacement. 5 strong innings by Buckles. And Bugs is bringing it, sidearm, and it's, did he go? He did not. He'll peel the first base umpire, 1-1. Cyclones head to the beach next week. Playing Fort Dorchester. They'll play Abingdon, Virginia down the beach. They'll get some, there's a hit batsman. They'll get some downtime. Coach Preston up here in the post game. We'll see exactly what they're going to be able to do. I'm sure they're going to the beach because they're going to be there.
Now batting number 5, Connor Roos.
Here's Connor Roos. Bugs brings it, fouls it back, jams him. Hello, Ernie Campbell. They will play. Let's see what we got here when they go down. Monday, Fort Dorchester. Tuesday, Fort Dorchester. Wednesday, Abingdon. Wednesday, they'll play playing. Yep. Wednesday, Abington. Thursday, Phillip Simmons. Friday, James Island. Before they come back home, they play every day, which they should. Swing and a miss. Nice pitch. Hello, Debbie Stout. How you doing, lady? Two outs in the inning here in the top of the sixth. Cyclones lead it 5-2. Runner at first. Meadows in relief of Jackson Buckles, who was sparkling today. Runner going, swing and a miss. Throw down to second. It won't matter. Runner's out, and so is the inning. Or the batter's out, so is the inning. Strikeout swinging, and we go to the bottom of the sixth inning. And the Cyclones own a 5-2 lead. We'll be right back after this. You're watching Elizabethan Cyclone Baseball. Now this from one of the folks making it go, the good folks from Physical Therapy Services.
Talking to Dr. Justin Smith, one of our great sponsors here at the Tom Dillard Sports Show, Elizabethan Cyclone Sports. A lot of them out there. What do you feel like separates Physical Therapy Services from all the competition?
Well, number one is that we're local. The money that you spend with us stays here. Mm-hmm. This is not a large corporate venture that your money goes to Florida or Miami or up to Chicago or wherever. We are a true mom-and-pop facility. We pride ourselves on that, number one. Number two, we don't have a bunch of higher-ups, VPs, multiple presidents that we have to end up making a bunch of profit to be able to pad their pockets. The money that we make in Physical Therapy Services, we reinvest back into the community. So that's why we have our Class 4 laser, we have our Alter-G, we have all the equipment that nobody else in the area has. And we can provide services and for the people of Elizabethton, of Carter County, Run Mountain, Hampton, Stony Creek, Mountain City, Johnson City. That's why we have people from all over the area that flock to our facility because they know they're going to get the best care, the state-of-the-art care with the most state-of-the-art equipment.
It's awesome. Can't top that, folks. Great sponsor of the Tom Dillard Sports Show and Elizabethan Cyclone Sports. The great folks at Physical Therapy Services.
Bottom of the sixth, Cyclones up 5-2. It's Braden Buckles comes calling here for the Cyclones. Downstairs, bounced up there. Again, second inning of work for Watson. Buckles, Campbell, and Blevins. 7-8-9, and the Cyclone 6. We lead it 5-2. Trying to nail down 2 out of 3 this week. Beating Unicoi County, getting beat last night by a good Dobbins Minute team. 12-2, a run rule. In 5 innings, they can play. Ryan Wagner's got him another ball club in Kingsport this year. 2-0 pitch. Good eye by Buckles, and it's 3-0. Buckles a fly out to right and a strikeout. He's 0-2 in that 7 spot. Pitch, and it's inside a tight ball, 4-on-4. Buckles will trot to first, a leadoff walker in the 6th. Hello, Stephanie Witcher. Here's Campbell, a single walk and a run scored in a stolen base. Actually, 2 runs scored in a stolen base. So 1-for-1, a walk. Scored both times he got on and stole a base. For number one, made a big defensive catch early in the game for the Cyclones out in left field. Stairs, ball one. Did you have a good day at school? Okay. He says, nah. Okay. It's what? Don't let your mother hear that. Yep. What? Your lunch table was all gone. Everybody didn't come back today. Gotcha. Bunt, first base side. Campbell's got some wheels. Fielded by Watson. Nice play. Sacrifice bunt. Got him down. Good job by the pitcher to field it. And Campbell to put it right there to allow our guy to get down there.
Now batting number 5, Jack Blevins.
Down to second goes Buckles. Campbell's retired. One away for Jack Blevins. Blevins. A sack bunt and a fielder's choice. She said she can hear you, so there you go. So all your buddies were gone today. Swinging them in. Wasn't anybody at the table, right? Lunch table? All gone. You're by yourself?
No.
Oh. Hello, Travis Royston. I don't ever see you being by yourself. I think you're too much of a people person. 0-1 pitch to the one-out batter. Runner coming down to third. Here's the throw. High throw, and he's in. Stolen base for the Cyclones. Nice job. So Blevins has him in scoring position. Let's see if he can deliver. One out, one on here. Bottom of the sixth and a scheduled seven. Infield pulled in for the plate to plate. Blevins squares the bunt, pulls it back, and it's a strike call. 1-2. Spring break started today here at Elizabethan City Schools. Buckles down at third. 1-2 pitch. Ground ball to the diving third baseman. Nice play. Knocks it down. Throws. And he'll be safe at first base. Good hustle, Jack Blevins. Infield base hit. Nice job down at third to knock it down by the Morristown West third baseman. He did an excellent job. Connor Roos.
Bryson Rowland.
The Blevins hustling down the line. Gets an infield base hit. Number six for the Cyclones. Staying at third as Buckles got him on the corners. Here's Rowland, 2-for-3 in that lead spot. A triple to start the game. A strikeout swinging and an RBI single in the fourth inning. He's 2-for-3 in the lead spot. Got him on the corners from insurance runs here. We're up 3 in the bottom of the sixth inning. Upstairs, ball one. Cyclones got him on the corners here. One out of the bottom of the sixth. Morristown West has three more outs. Hello to Robert Reese. How you doing, sir? And Carolyn Williams. And a strike called. Is that my little buddy? It is. That's my little buddy from Chick-fil-A, Carolyn Williams. Makes me the Frosted Mango Passion. Oh, they're good. Me, oh my. I might get one on the way home. You hungry? You're always hungry. You're exactly right. Jiminy Christmas. Throw to first on the pickoff play. Down to second goes Blevins, and they got him. 1-3-6. Caught stealing. Two down here. So rolling with the runner down to third. Buckles is even bring him in. Two outs in the inning. And it's down and away. Good eye by Bryson Rowland. He was our player of the game last night. Two balls, one strike. Brings it outside and away, 3-1. We're a little past the 6 o'clock hour on a Friday night. We're into the bottom of the sixth inning. Elizabethan leads it 5-2. Watson brings it, and it's a swing. Did he go? And he did, and there's a strike beside his name at 3-2 now. Hello, Audra Millsaps. How you doing, lady? I always appreciate the ladies listening and the guys, too, of course. Everybody out there in internet land, we appreciate you. Full count. Outside ball four, and Roland tosses the bat down to first of your scampers.
Now batting number 10, Jariah.
Here's Jariah Gribben, the roadrunner, an RBI in the first, a hit batsman, a run scored in the third, and a strikeout to end the fourth inning. Got him on the corners. Two out, two on here in the sixth inning. So we lose at Unicoi County, back to beat him the next night. Fastball strike call to Dry. Lose to Dobbins Minute, and we're three outs away from beating Morristown West here, but that's been our week for Cyclone Baseball. We'll be 2-2. Way upstairs. Here comes the runner from third. Buckles will go in, sliding head first. He got it. Smart play by Buckles. Did the head first slide down to third, and he's safe at third base. So Buckles in, sliding, makes it a 6-2 ball game, and Blevins or check to Campbell down to third. Bang, bang play down there. Great throw, great take, but a great slide to the outfield side of the bag to get him in there for Logan Campbell. So Dryer's got run number 7, 90 feet away here. And he takes a big rip and fouls it back. 1-2. Hello, Jamie and Sarah Jones. I know it's not like a broken record, but I can't thank you all enough for watching and listening to our broadcast. Means the world to me. Hello, Debbie Whitson. Melissa Minton. Here's a swing and a miss. Jariah Griffin strikes out swinging, but we pick up a big insurance run in the inning. We go to the 7th. It's do or die for Morristown West. Come back with us. We lead it after 6. Cyclones lead it 6-2. You're watching Elizabethan Cyclone Baseball. Now this from one of the folks making a go. Couldn't be here without them, I'm telling you. Without our sponsors, we wouldn't be bringing the broadcast. Don't forget that. Here is Northeast Community Credit Union.
Tom Taylor Sports Show. Got a brand new product. Tell me what's going on.
We sure do. We have contactless Visa debit cards. And some of you all have been asking and wanting to know, when are you going to implement that? We are hitting the ground running. So right now you can get your free instant issue contactless debit cards at Northeast Community Credit Union, and that's just another form of payment. So you've got the mag strip on the back, you've got your contactless invisible, what you want to call it, if you want to pay that way for tapless, or you've got your chip. So we're just staying up to date with all the things, and we listened to you. So you wanted that, and that's what we can provide. And we've implemented it with hard work behind the scenes, a lot of teamwork effort, and come get your contactless Visa debit card today.
Available now.
Yes.
At all locations. Our locations are?
They are in Rhode Mountain. They are in Elizabethan, one in behind Elizabethan High School, our main office. And then we have one off of 19E in Elizabethan. We have one in Johnson City off of West Oakland Avenue.
Social media, how do we find you?
You can find us at Facebook, Instagram, or bemycu.org.
And the magic main number is?
423-547-1200.
Brand new product from Northeast Community Credit Union. Proud sponsor of the Tom Taylor Sports Show and Cyclone Sports.
Batting number 2, Charlie Newell.
We come back to the 7th inning. Hello to Jamie and Sarah Jones. Thank you. Doug Henshaw, hello, Preacher Doug, and Michelle and Louis Krosick, maybe. Opening play, Watson hit a shot to Jack Blevins, hit it right at him, and he knocked it down and bobbled the ball for a moment, and he's on with an error, is Watson. A strike called now to Charlie DeWald. We're in the top of the 7th. Cyclones lead it 5-2. Trying to end it right here on a cloudy, overcast night of the ballpark. Brings it, Meadows swing and a miss. Brings it three-quarter, brings it sidearm. It's tough to pick up because, as we told you, if you'll watch his body language, he's working from the stretch now, but he still has that left foot pointed to kind of block his body, and he reaches out that time, and self-defense, bad-handled foul ball, first base side. Phil does look great, you're right. Artificial turf now, thanks to Boyd Sports and the City of Elizabethan and Elizabethan City Schools. Did it both here and on our softball field. It's all about the kids. Bugs, Meadows, the 1-2 pitch. Foul back, just got a piece of it. Again, Meadows, you look at left lead foot, he'll, instead of pointing towards the batter, points towards the third base foul line. And blocks the ball and shields it with his body. It's tough to pick up. You're a batter. See, look right here. Watch him. Comes out of nowhere. Sidearm. It's bounced up there. Hooks throws down to second. Pretty good throw. Got him. Oh, boy. J.D. Hooks a bullet to second. Hooks on a rocket to second, throws him out, one away. Cots dealing on a 2-6. Morristown West coach didn't like that, but that was a heck of a throw by J.D. Hooks. Put it right on the bag. All Red Slagle had to do is catch it and apply the tag. It was right there and got him on the throw. 2-6 on the putout. One away in the seventh inning here. DeWall to strike out, a ground out, and a sack fly RBI, and he fouls this one back. So Bugs Meadows in relief and starter Jackson Buckles. Yes, he does. He has a cannon. J.D. Hooks is the first time we've been able to see it this season. On a rope down to second. Threw it right on the top of the bag. That's exactly where you want it. 1-2 pitch and swing and a miss. Double C Western Supply strikeout. Two down to the game. Two away for Bryson Shepherd. Bugs Meadows doing a great job in relief of the starter Jackson Buckles here. Shepherd, two strikeouts and a walk today. He's 0 for 2. Down to the final out of the ball game. Cyclones leading at 6-2 here. Swing and a miss. Bugs bringing it. Whew. Off tomorrow, traveling Monday, Fort Dorchester down in Charleston. Playing every day next week. Inside a tight, and they come back, and we get into it hot and heavy. Sullivan Easton here on Tuesday, April the 2nd. We'll have that one for you. In fact, we got Sullivan Easton Thursday, the 4th of April. We'll be playing Daniel Boone at Hunter Wright Stadium in Kingsport. Swing and a miss. Then on Saturday the 6th, we'll come back and bring you Pikeville, Kentucky at Cardinal Park in Johnson City. Our next broadcast will be Monday, April the 1st, April Fools, the Folds of Honor softball game, honoring the Folds of Honor organization, inside and tight. So softball will be at Hilton Head, and the guys will be in Charleston next week, spring break. Hello, Mona Stout. How you doing, lady? Two balls, two strikes, two outs in the ballgame. Cyclones up four here, top of the seventh. Bugs brings it, and it's ball four. He lost him. On the payoff pitch, obviously. And hello, Karen Schneider. How you doing, lady? You're becoming regular, and I appreciate that very much. Here's Cody Blair, 0 for 2 of the walk here, the cleanup batting catcher for Morristown West. First pitch, fly ball, base hit to left field. Campbell to pick it up, and Logan gets it right back in for a two-out single, only the third hit of the game for Morristown West. First one off Bugs.
Now batting number 14, Paxton Seal.
Here's Seal, the fifth batter in the lineup. A walk, a strikeout, and a ground out to second. I'm doing good, Karen. Thank you, ma'am. Eleanor Rambo, Southport, North Carolina, right there on the coast. I wish I was there tonight after the game, just walk out on the beach. Was there, what was it, last year? Inside and tight, bows him back with a fastball. At Southport, North Carolina Beach. Man, it was awesome. Hello, Rhonda Hubbard. How you doing, lady? Upstairs, misses. 3-0, raining in Southport. It's going to be raining here in a little while. Calling for rain while we move the game up. 3-0 now. Brings it, and it's ball 4-on-4, and they've loaded them up here. Two out in the ball game. Old gut check time here. 5-2, we lead it. I'm sorry, 6-2, we lead it. Here's Malachi Isom as one of the three base hits in the ball game. So bases loaded, two out. Hooks will talk to his pitcher, Bugs Meadows, and here we go. Trojans at all three bases here.
Number 8, Malachi Isom.
So here's Isom. 6-2 Cyclones, two out. Bases loaded, Morristown West, bottom of the, or top of the seventh. Inside a tight ball one. 1-0 pitch. Fastball. Strike called. 1-1. E4, strikeout, swinging, walk, single walk. Bases loaded here. 1-1 pitch. Downstairs, 2-1. If it continues, Gavin Mitchell, pitcher, now center fielder on deck. Bugs, 2-1 pitch. Ball three, looked pretty good down here. J.D. Hookster, I even looked at the umpire. And I'd have to agree, that looked pretty good from here. However, I'm up here. It's 3-1. Meadows right back, and it's a called strike, full count now. Bugs put it right back in the same place. This time it was a strike. Meadows with the baseball says, I'm ready, boys. Let's go. I'm ready to roll here. Full count. Here it comes. 3-2. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Cyclones win. Orange and black win. And Elizabethan wins and avenges the 5-1 loss down there. Final score, Cyclones 6. And Morristown West 2, we go to 4-5 on the season. They fall to 7-3. Cyclones win in a poor draft. Deli players the game. We'll visit with Jackson Buckles and Rhett Slagle.
Thank you for coming to the park tonight. Again, we'd like to say a special thank you.
Cyclones win it. Final score, 6-2. We'll be right back after this. You're watching Elizabethan Cyclone Baseball. Now this from Rick Walters, Horseman Insurance.
On April the 2nd against Sullivan East. Thank you for coming and have a safe trip home.
Tell me, we don't talk a lot about it, Gabe. Tell me about the cold subs. Tell me about those in Port Travis, would you please?
So our cold subs, they come with they come in two different sizes, 12-inch, 6-inch, and they come with bologna, salami, ham, cheese, and then we can put whatever you want on it, and they come pre-made. We can get you in out of here pretty quick.
6-inch or 12-inch?
Yes, sir.
6-inch is how much?
6-inch is $5.19, and a 12-inch is $6.49.
You couldn't make it for that. You couldn't go buy the bread. There's no way you could go buy the bread and make what they're going to do for you for that kind of price. The cold sub, 6-inch or 12-inch. They also sell salads. Tell me about the salads.
So we got a house salad that comes with, you know, cheese, tomato, croutons, and then two packs of dressing of your choice. And we can also throw our special signature onions on them. And then the chef salad comes with the same thing, but we can throw any type of meat you want on there. So a house salad is $6.29, and then the chef salad is $7.49.
Not going to bust your billfold, folks, and you get a salad, too. They don't scrimp. That's kind of the motto. We don't scrimp. If you get a sandwich on those hot subs, we don't scrimp. So what's you're here all the time. What's the top three sandwiches you guys make day in and day out?
Ham and cheese, most popular. I'd say second to that, probably Mad Italian, and then third is probably a Reuben.
Yep. The Mad Italian is what? What do you get on it?
So you get ham, turkey, cheese, and then we can throw everything on there for you.
We got 10 cases of drinks over here, everything, Pepsi products, Coke products, energy drinks, got all that. We got we run through all the different Wise, Cape Cod, Tom's, Lance's, Doritos, Cheetos, got all the different kinds of chips.
Yes, sir.
All right here. Phone number to call is?
I actually don't know that part.
543-6128. 6128. Poor Trav Deli, they also sponsor our player of the game, folks. Every time a kid plays ball, again, from Elizabeth or Tia Duggar, we give them a Poor Trav Deli player of the game. We appreciate that very much. Gabe Sexton, folks, one of our great sponsors right here, working hard.
Yes, sir.
At Poor Trav's Deli. Hey, this is Tom Taylor. Here in 2024, the Tom Taylor Sports Show is now on TikTok. That's right. Lots of cool things coming all year long, again, on TikTok. Be sure and like us, share it, and follow by hitting the plus button. So, a lot of neat things coming. Please get on board with us. Like, share, or follow by hitting the plus button. The Tom Taylor Sports Show, now in 2024, on TikTok. Final score, 6-2 Cyclones. As Elizabethan improves to 4-5 on the season. Let's get him right here. Here's our head coach. There we go. I don't think they really want to see me. They want to see you. Hello, Lowe's Benfield. Hello to Andrew McKeon. Congratulations. That's Cyclone Baseball. I like that, sir.
Yeah, it was clean. That is what it's supposed to look like.
Did you say clean?
Yeah, it was clean. That's what we were going for last night.
Last night.
There at the end, we got to dress up. We just let's focus a little bit at the end, but very close to a very complete game effort. Very timely hitting, moving runners like we should, stealing bases like we should, playing defense for the most part like we should. Pitching, my goodness, get some of that.
Tell you what.
Yeah. Jackson Buckles.
Oh baby.
Incredible.
Oh baby.
So that's what we're looking for from him. You know, the model we're using with getting these guys to 70 and having solid relief is good. You know, it's something we worked really hard for in the offseason, preparing all kinds of guys to start games. And these guys have responded really well. Coach Bembry has done a great job. He does a good job calling pitches, picking up where Coach Casey left off of having a super professional pitching coach that's raising these guys the right way. So I'm very proud of a nearly complete game effort. And we'll go back to the drawing board and get ready to go to the beach and try to go down there and make some noise, see what we got.
I thought a big part of this game, Buckles struck out the first two, loaded the bases, and struck out the last guy in the first. Thought that was a gut check. Had 8 strikeouts tonight. Buckles was on. He was a man among boys.
Yeah, and when he throws strikes, like it's so hard as a hitter to hit that because the angle at which the ball's coming in and the curveball's coming out of the slider and the curveball and the changeups are all coming out of that same tunnel. It just looks like the same pitch until it gets to about a cut in front of the plate, and then it just does something, you know. And that fastball, really good spin rate, sits up top, guys swinging under it, hitting pop flies. You know, we love pop flies. Those are easy outs, you know. So, yeah, very impressed with him. Going to rest that arm a little bit and put him to use at the beach next week.
We beat a good baseball team today. They go to 7-3. We go to 4-5. Then how about the big hit, the hit tonight, Slagle up the wall, bases clearing double, big time 3 RBI hit. That was the telltale for our offense.
Yeah, I think if that wind's not blowing across that baseball, if it's behind it, it's definitely gone. I think if there's no wind, I think it's gone. So that's what we're looking for. Bases loaded, 2 outs. You could feel the pressure relief valve blow. Everybody's hats flew off. You know, like if I'd have had a long beard, it'd have been blowing in the wind. But you didn't even notice the beard.
I did.
Did you?
You trimmed it. Yeah, looks good.
I told you last night. Yeah. Well, I kind of misled folks. I said it was coming off.
Well, you trimmed it
all the way off.
It's okay.
But we changed it up. Everybody changed something today. I said everybody got to change something, and we changed something and scored. I mean, I really am happy with that line. You know, the constant pressure on that line, even the innings we had zero, I don't think we went 1-2-3 in one inning. And that's what this offense can do. We've got so many hitters that can just pester you to death and just get on a base, and we're getting good leads, we're getting good secondaries, we're taking bags. Like, you know, that's hard for a pitcher to try to concentrate getting some guy out when he's got all kinds of things going on around him. So good job by that offense, keeping the pressure on him, focusing in.
Big win.
Huge win.
Huge win.
Huge win. I mean, I'll just be honest with you, like that's a team that I think will probably win that conference down there. I think when it's all said and done, because that lineup is legit. I mean, you saw those kids coming up there. I mean, Coach Pickett has done an awesome job developing those kids. And those kids have been playing 2 and 3 years. They got some older guys. They got a little bit of youth mixed in there with it, but just a good-looking ball club. Expect big things out of them. But, yeah, you know, we've been with them 3 times now. We scrimmaged them. Had it tight until the bottom of the seventh or top of the seventh, and it just kind of got away from us. Went down there last time, played them really tight, 5-1. We're not scoring the runs we need to score. And then tonight, able to see development, improvement, and flip it on its head. You know, last night, man, was super discouraging for us. We didn't compete. And as a coach, man, I can take a loss. But and as a competitor, these kids, I mean, we had an awesome meeting last night, and we talked about some tough stuff and just kind of laid it out there. And I was really hoping it would have some result today. You know, not necessarily win, but just a competitive edge. And they responded. They went home, got a few hours of sleep, went to school today, and came out here at 4:30. That's a beautiful thing too, right? Like, we don't need the big lights. So we'll play at 4:30 with, you know, light crowd. Friday afternoon baseball, we're on spring break next week, and come out here and have a really good effort like that. I'm proud of them.
Well, you had 2 gut checks this week. You go to Unicoi County and lose that one. That was a tough one over there in the cold, but you come back the next night here and gut check and beat a good Unicoi County team in the conference. Last night we got run ruled by a very good Dobbins Minute team. Which team's going to show up tonight? Cyclone Pride came back and showed me some grit again. 6-2 win over a good Morristown West team. So we're off to the beach. Play every day next week, and we come back and we jump into the conference. big time on Monday and Tuesday with Solomon East. So here we go.
Yeah, it's part of the plan.
Oh yeah,
the schedule is a nightmare, and it's there on purpose. I don't want to go 10-0, and then hit the middle of the stretch and hit a little tough patch, and then they end up your 10-10. Like if we got to beat back from behind, by golly, we're Cyclones. We'll do that. So I'm going to give these guys the opportunity to get better. You know, if we're not coming out here on a daily basis trying to get better, even if we're playing, then we're not going to be there at the end of the year. And I want to see what these kids can do at the end of the year. I mean, that could be electric for these kids. So excited to continue to develop, take a trip with them, go down there and watch them run around on the beach and look at girls because they won't talk to girls, which is fine. And
that's
see how many awkward
want.
Moments we can create with a bunch of high school kids. So, and they're good at it. God bless them. I love them.
Congratulations.
Yeah, man.
Go Thank Cyclones. You. Love you. Let's get these guys in here, players of the game. Let's start. I don't care. It doesn't matter to me which one. Hello, Phoebe Ollie. Hello, Carolyn Neidifer. Who's coming first? Let's go alphabetically. Buckles will come first. Nope. Slagle's first. There we go. It's all right. You spoke. Let me get out of the way. They don't want to see me. Let's get by where they can see you guys. Big, tell me about the hit, sir. That one wasn't too far. I'm going out here. It's a big time hit. Tell us about that hit in the inning for you.
Yes, sir. My first at bat, I mean, saw a couple pitches. Kid has a nice knuckleball. He got me on the first one. I rolled it over to the shortstop, and I knew his approach. It was to spin me, and he left a fastball over the middle of the second at bat, and I peppered it to left center gap.
You peppered it all right.
I thought it was out. I
did too.
I kind of jog at second base.
Yeah, I thought it was out too. He hammered it, and it's halfway up the wall, and it didn't miss by much going out. Cleared the bases. That was the big hit of the ball game. So, as I told Coach Preston before you sit down here, big gut check. You lose the Unicoi County, come back and beat them here. You get run ruled last night by DB. We're better than that, and you know that. But they're a good ball club.
Yeah.
But then you come back tonight and gut check against this team. It's a good ball club. That's a good sign for our team, isn't it?
Yes, sir, it is. I think it goes to show that a lot of stuff doesn't affect us.
Yep.
Yes, sir.
We just go with it. We go with the flow. And so now you head off the beach and get ready to play some down there and come back and get into the big conference race. So got a lot of good baseball ahead of us. This team's fun to watch.
Yes, sir.
And you're fun to watch. You had some big plays down in third today too, sir.
I appreciate that.
So you poor Travis Deli, what's your favorite sandwich here?
Just ham and cheese, light mayo.
There you go. Saw your father the other day. I was eating lunch here before the game. He came in and got a sandwich, and so the Slagle's there all the time. Get you a free sandwich, sir. Congratulations.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Go Cyclones. Red Slagle, one of our players of the game. Let's get the other guy in here. Man, big Mamba. Well, I don't know how. Big Mojo. I don't want to call a guy. He could bring it. He brought it to the night against Unicoi County. Oh, by the way, Rhett, give this to Bryson. I forgot to give him yesterday's. Jackson Buckles. Tell me about that first inning. You got in a jam and you just got checked and hung in there, buddy. Tell me about it.
Well, I got the first two out, and then I just something changed. They started getting, I started walking some, and then I think I got the bases loaded, and then I struck the last guy out.
You did?
So that was big.
Struck out the first two, loaded the bases, and struck out the last guy to get the inning. So big game. 8 strikeouts for Jackson Buckles. Did you feel it out there? At what point did you tell yourself, hey, dude, hey, dog, I got this. I got a little mojo going. Could you feel it? Did you know it?
Yeah, about the second or third, once we went through the lineup, like, about one or two times, I felt good, felt confident, felt like I just go through everybody.
We'll beat a good ball club tonight. Forestown West is a good team. So now 7-3. We're getting better every game. We're a young team. So guys, head off the beach, come back next week after next. Big, big week of baseball. We're going to be there with you. So enjoy the beach. What do you like down at Port Travis Deli? What's your favorite sandwich?
Probably like turkey cheese, some pickles, mayonnaise.
Now he's talking. Yeah. So, big boy right here. Brought it in. Big guy.
Thank you, Tom.
Thank you, sir. 8 strikeouts for Jackson Buckles, and that's going to do it again from here as we wrap things up here. Final score, little Brenda Grindstaff and David Lacey and Colin Neidifer. And so, let's put it out there if you don't care, please. And Phoebe Holly, Carolyn Neidifer, Roger Brown, Christy Rowland, Lennell Younts, Deb Googe. Final score, 6-2 Cyclones. Players of the game, obviously, you saw just now, the players of the game were and are Red Slagle, and Jackson Buckles. Buckles struck out eight, got the win. And the big hit, almost out of your breath. Good night. Big time hit by Red Slagle. Bases clearing double halfway up the left field wall. That was it for the Cyclones. We win it going away. 6-2 start early because of the rain. It's a good thing. It's starting to rain here at the ballpark. So, final score. Cyclones win it 6 runs on 6 hits for Elizabeth and 2 runs, 3 hits for the Morristown West Trojans. That'll do it. Back with you a week from Monday will be our next broadcast. We'll be ready to go on April the 1st, and we'll have softball, the Folds of Honor game against Happy Valley, and baseball that week. A lot of baseball. It's the month of April. Man, we got wall-to-wall baseball and softball for you. So, for our superintendent, Richard Van Hus, our principal, Dr. John Mitten, also for our head baseball coach, Ryan Preslin, for Tucker Taylor, a cameraman, with help tonight from Carrie to Tucker, got here from soccer practice. This is Tom Taylor telling you the finals. The rain's coming now. Final score, Cyclones win it 6-2. Have yourself a good weekend. If you don't have a church home, please consider coming to Pleasant Beach Baptist Church. We'd love to see you and have you come worship with us, the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Let's wrap it up as we always do with the verse of the day. 2 Corinthians 9:8 will be the verse as we approach the 7 o'clock hour. And it goes like this, our verse of the day. Let's see, let me hit the right buttons here and get it up here so we can tell you what the verse of the day is. It is 2 Corinthians 9:8. And God is able to make all grace, every favor and earthly blessing, come to you in abundance, so that in all things at all times, having all that you need, you will abound in every good work. 2 Corinthians 9:8. Good way to end it. Thanks for watching the broadcast. Final score, Cyclones win 6-2. Till we greet you again on Monday. This is Tom Taylor telling you, as always, bloom where you're planted and win or lose, be a good sport. Thanks for watching Elizabethan Cyclone Baseball, winner 6-2.